today is Saturday and I'm going to post a video, and this chapter will conclude chapter number 5. This is called Factors of Production, and this is the last topic we are going to discuss today. Factors of Production, last topic from ICC point of view. We are going to prepare ourselves for examination, and few minor topics I have left it out. A brief concept explanation I'll give you when we shall resume the class. This is for your examination, and a very important concept. You, dear children, you know very well that factors of production we have divided into land, labor, capital, and the fourth factor was entrepreneurship, entrepreneur. We have completed land, labor, capital, and this is the last topic we are going to discuss today. And with this, we will be concluding chapter number 5, factors of production, capital, and entrepreneur. First, who is an entrepreneur? An entrepreneur is a person who performs all these important functions. An entrepreneur is a person who organizes production, manages business, takes important decisions, hires factors of production, and bears risks and factors of uncertainties. He is an entrepreneur. Now, when we say he organizes business, what does it mean? It means that it is his duty to coordinate. Let me first say you in short, entrepreneur is the owner of a business. Like if I want to start a factory, I need land, I will need labor, people to work in my factory, I will need machines, so land, labor, capital, and I myself will be required there. Somebody to boss over, somebody to manage, somebody to give instruction, somebody to guide them, innovate them, and somebody to look after them and see whether everything is being is on right track or not. So that person is an entrepreneur. So entrepreneur is a person who organizes business. So organizing business means to bring all the factors of production together. That's called a coordination. He is a person who coordinates all other factors of production. Manages business means looks after business. If the business requires an important decision, he has to take. If the business is in need of some important factors, it is he who has to provide. The laborers will stop working saying that they don't have material. So it is the master who has to make arrangement and take proper management. So that is a management part he has to take care. Takes important decisions regarding how much to produce, how long to produce, at what price should it be sold, where should the commodities be sent, how many laborers are to be hired. Important decisions he takes. Hires factors of production. These are the factors of production. He has to buy land. Entrepreneur has to buy land, and he has to see which labor is to be hired, whether it is how many skilled laborers, how many unskilled laborers, how many semi-skilled laborers, how many technicians, what kind of capital, what kind of machines are to be used. So all these are the factors of production, and he has to hire them. Hire means employ them. Next is bears risk and factors of production. Somebody has to be there who has to bear the risk. If I start a business and if the business go in a loss, then who actually have to bear the loss? Will the laborers bear the loss? It is me myself who will have to bear the loss. So then I am an entrepreneur. So an entrepreneur is a person who organizes production, manages business, takes important decisions, hires factors of production, and also bears risk and factors of uncertainties. Uncertainties means unseen factors. So many factors, so many problems will come which are unseen. Like government in the days to come may introduce a policy that may go against your business. So that is a factor unseen. So that are the uncertainty factors concerning uncertainties. Like you have produced a lot, but there is a landslide and the road is blocked. That is a factor of uncertainties. You did not know about it. Then you have to take important decision what to do. Should you stop the production or shall you divert the road or transportation? How to manage such kind of important decision he has to say. That person who takes these important decisions are called entrepreneur. So this is the concept of entrepreneur. Now, functions of an entrepreneur. What function does an entrepreneur perform? Entrepreneur performs a very important function, the most vital function, and now we are going to discuss the same. So the functions of an entrepreneur, dear children, I have written the three important functions of an entrepreneur. An entrepreneur is a very important person. He is just like the principal of a school. He is just like the manager of a farm, provided the manager himself is the entrepreneur. He is just like the boss. He is just like the driver of a bus. Though the driver, I presume that he is the master. I mean, he is the proprietor. So, has to perform a very important function. You have come to know, by now you have come to know who is an entrepreneur. Now it is important for us to understand what role does he have to perform. These are the important roles performed by the entrepreneur. The first is the coordination. Coordination means all he is an entrepreneur, these are the factors of production, this has to come together. Only then the production begins or production starts. If I have land and no labor, and if I have land and capital but no labor, then production may not begin, will not begin. I need to have the first the land, I need to construct, I need to bring the capital, machines, tools, everything, and then I need to hire the laborers, only then the production will begin. I need to bring the raw materials. So that is a coordination. I need to coordinate, I need to bring all the factors of production together at a place. It is my duty as an entrepreneur. Then management, I have to take care, I have to look after whether the production is taking place in the desired direction or not. Management is a very important factor. Management means to see whether all the laborers are sincerely working or not. It is to see that the production is produced in the right quality and the quantity. It is management also involves reaching the produced commodity into the hand of the consumer, managing all the vehicles, transportation, communication, everything is called a management, is a part of management. And it is the most important part of function of an entrepreneur. It is the entrepreneur who has to perform this duty, and no other person can do this or is allowed to do this. So important function, the first important function is that of coordination and management. Second function is risk-taking. Risk-taking, this is a very important function, and this is the, let me tell you, labor and entrepreneur. Both are in a way the same. Labor is a person who is working for the factory or farm or industry. Entrepreneur is also the same person who is working for the farm factory. So in one way they are the same. Both refers to man. Land is not man. Capital is not man. Okay, yeah, I consider tools and technology as the capital. But labor and entrepreneur are persons. They are man. So they are very similar to each other. What makes difference? How is labor different from entrepreneur is because of this. Labor does not be a risk. Entrepreneur has to be a risk. Labor gets salary. Entrepreneur does not get salary. The residual amount all belongs to you. That means after making the payment to every head, whatever is left over, everything belongs to entrepreneur. So these two important factors makes the labor different from entrepreneur. I suppose this is clear to you. Now, let me give you another concept. Let us come back to this topic. This is risk taking. Risk is an important factor. I may start a business and may fail. Then all the losses I have to bear. It is not borne by any other person. That is a big important factor and the most important factor. Risk bearing. Who bears the risk? And you know, risk, nobody would like to bear it. So the person who bears is an entrepreneur. It is the owner who always have to bear the risk. and bearing uncertainties. A moment ago I told you all the factors of uncertainties. These all have to be borne by the entrepreneur, and this is his function, his important function. Uncertainties means you have produced a lot, but there is no supply. There may not be any supply. There is a change in the policy of the government, so because of that you have to bear the risk. So that change in the policy of the government is a factor of uncertainty. Because of the heavy rainfall, there was a landslide and the road is blocked. So this is a factor referring to the uncertainties. So these are some of the examples of uncertainties, and because of this, the business may be at risk. So the risk factor and bearing uncertainties is an important factor or function of an entrepreneur. The next one is innovation. Innovation means invention. Now what does it mean? An entrepreneur always needs to be innovative. Why does he need to be innovative? He needs to be innovative because it is his duty to produce in the best of the quality at the cheapest rate. Because the better the quality means higher will be the sale, and cheaper the price or cheaper the cost of production. Cost of production means the cost required in producing a commodity. The lesser it is, more will be the profit. Try to understand. The quality of a product that is being produced should be good, because it has to compete in the market. It has to satisfy the need of the consumer. So they will be happy. But what about the farm and the factory? The farm and factory will flourish if the commodity which they are producing are good in quality, and if it is produced at a cheaper rate of production. If it is being produced at a cheaper rate, because if they can produce at lower rate, then the profit or the margin of the profit for the entrepreneur will be more, and the farm and the factory will flourish. And for this, the entrepreneur always need to be innovative. He must always try to find out the ways, means and how, so that he can produce the maximum quantity at the minimum cost. So he can replace one machine by another machine, or his decision should be such that when he takes a decision, that decision flourishes for him, that decision comes out to be very, very correct for him. So he need to be innovative. Innovative means invention. Try to find out new methods by means of which it will ease the work for everybody. For the workers as well as for the farm and factory, it increases the production, reduces the cost of production, and also when it falls into the hand of the consumer, consumer likes it. Okay, so this is the innovative, because of the innovation. And such kind of entrepreneur will have his farm and factory existing for a long time. Example is that of Lizard Papad. Example is that of Parle-G biscuit. When we were kids, we used to have this Marie biscuit. It was long when we used to get this Marie biscuit. It was different quality, quantity, looks were totally different. But every year, every second year, there is a kind of changes coming in the quality as well as in the looks. So this is the innovative thoughts, the innovative ideas, and such innovative thoughts and ideas are to be there in an entrepreneur in order to make his farm and factory exist for a very long time. So these are some of the important functions of an entrepreneur. I suppose it is clear to you. Today it was a very short video on the entrepreneur. We learned about the concept of entrepreneur, the meaning of entrepreneur, and the important functions performed by the entrepreneur. And with this, dear children, we come to wind up chapter number 5, that was the factors of production, capital and entrepreneur, and we conclude this. But remember, there at the end of the exercise, there are some important questions. Please choose all those questions which were covered there in our class. And if you have any doubts, then please do call me and start working on them. Soon I will be asking your work. I will be asking you to submit your work. So please do complete your work and take care of yourself. Have a great day. Thank you.